Hey guys, it is Saturday morning, just a bit after 10 a.m. And there's a couple of yard sales that I want to check out. Well, there's actually just one on Walmer Road, and they had some neat stuff, but it turns out my GoPro was out of batteries, so I don't have any footage of it. And I kind of just rode around for a bit. I think I didn't mention it yesterday, but I did get an email saying that my e-bike wheel is done and that I can go pick it up. So after checking out another yard sale and not having footage of it, I'm heading down to Urbane to get my wheel. And they open up at 11, so I was there just a bit after opening. And Here's a bit of the shop. Lots of bikes here. Definitely overpriced. My wheel is looking pretty good, I gotta say. It is what they said it was gonna be. And it was expensive, how they, said it was gonna be. This is probably one of the longest receipts I've ever gotten. And it came to $593, so yeah, pretty much $600. They put the spokes in a kind of a unique way. They're both like facing the same direction, like the little J hook on the end. And the guy said that's on purpose, since the hub is not like perfectly centered. They like do that to get more spoke tension in it. So it is on purpose and supposed to be pretty strong like that. So yeah, I went back home, put on my disc brake thing, and I just used some electrical tape for the rim taping of it. It's actually kind of annoying because this rim needs a different inner tube than my other rim. I need a Presta valve. The hole is too small for just a regular Schrader valve, and it's just ever so slightly too small for it too. Really annoying, but whatever. $10, let's go. I got home and I was kind of tired, so I did eat some food, and then I was like kind of bored. Well, I opened up Pokemon Go while I was watching anime, and they're doing a community day, so then I kind of just like walked around Freshco while I was catching Pokemon and Pokemon Go. And looking at stuff. Yeah, I think I just bought some pop. I didn't really buy anything. But, I'm kind of like, I gotta put that wheel on soon, but I was a little bit putting it off. Just kind of thinking about having to pull everything out of my apartment, get the stand and stuff, and then just like, I'll get to it. But there's a part of me that's like, is it even going to be worth it? Like, it's not like Uber was busy any of the times that I've been on in the past while. So yeah, I just went for a bit of a walk and like was playing Pokemon. I'm catching some shiny Ponytas and stuff. And a bit of a ruckus going on there, I don't know. Anyways, finally go back home. And then I was like, hey, you know what? Maybe I don't have to pull out all my stuff. I can just put it on in the stand that it's hanging from off my wall. And that seemed to go fine. I've got it in. And like, actually from this angle, it's kind of easier to get it into the dropouts. So, that's cool. And tightened everything down. Give it a little test spin here. Seems good. I'm like, yeah. I feel like if you look just at the rim, it looks pretty true to me. That white stripe does make it look a little bit wobbly, but when I gave it an actual test ride, that's when disaster struck, guys. I'm like, what is this? Motor haul air? What does that mean? Yeah. So this is kind of something I was very worried about, is the axle has rotated and the electric wiring got all twisted and torn and shredded. It's a little bit fucked. So I know it wasn't Urbane's fault, because like you can see here the wire is fine. It's got to be something that I did. So I'm looking at it. I have the anti-rotational nuts are on there, but the axle has spun anyways. So now I'm bringing out all my stuff and getting it on the stand, taking it all apart, kind of deal. Yeah, you can see this is not the orientation you want to see your axle in. So, yeah. It's pretty low feeling right now as I take it apart and look at it. So here you can see the anti-rotational washer. I think part of what it was is that it's supposed to go in like that so the axle can be as deep into the jaw pass as it can be. But the first time I ever took off my wheel, I actually put it in the wrong way. I put it in, you know, with the nub going like that. And I think having it like that did a little bit of damage to the dropout and kind of made it have some wiggle room. And then over time, that wiggle room has grown and you can see some parts where it's like chewed up the dropouts a bit. And it's just kind of very unlucky timing that I just, you know, spent all that money getting this wheel fixed that it fucking ripped apart right now. You can see how round this one is too. So yeah, I don't know. I'm looking at the thing and there's definitely a lot of play with these washers. Like maybe they've just worn out over time. You know, that's one thing that Urbane guys could have told me. Like if they had been looking out for me, maybe they would have been like, hey, these washers should be replaced. And maybe that would have happened. But, you know, it wasn't their job to see how good my washers are. So I'm a little bit down. I'm actually extremely frustrated, and that's why I didn't post a video, because I felt like there was no solution here. It was just, I wasted a bunch of money on this and fucked up. And, you know, I'm like, Uber's over. So the next day, I spent the morning looking for jobs on Indeed. Apparently, veterinarian assistants, you don't, like, need any professional training for some of this stuff. I guess, you know, if they just need an extra pair of hands or someone who's down to clean up some dog piss and shit. I could do that. And the old standby nighttime work, working overnight. I could be a Planet Fitness guy. And, you know, look through some of my stuff I'm gonna try to sell. Like these Nintendo DSs that my dad gave me. Which I was kind of thinking after I got the 3DS a week ago, I should probably sell these. This is what I was kind of thinking, is that since, you know, River and Hero, they have the... Well, I have 3DSs for them. I would just sell these and then buy a 3DS for my dad and set it up in a similar way. Hopefully he'll be into Professor Layton and I can use the money from these kind of thing to go towards that. I did it in kind of reverse order, but yeah. It's a pretty decent bundle if you ask me. Again, trying to sell this Rock Band guitar. I mean, people go crazy for the drums, so we'll see about the guitar. But, yeah, in the afternoon, I was kind of looking at the street hub that I found a while ago. This e-bike motor. And, you know, I've I was planning on taking it apart at one point to have a look at what's going on the inside of a hub. And now seems like a good time to do it, so... yeah. It was pretty easy to take apart. You just take off this cap. And, I mean, whoever threw this one away must have already opened it up and stuff. Since, there wasn't really much holding it in place. Kind of cool to look at. It's got, like, these planetary gears. And, yeah. Motors. It's like, how did they come up with motors? But, anyways, looking at it, it is a wire that goes through the axle, and then it comes out near this circuit board. So I was kind of thinking, you know, what if I just cut off all the wires from this wire, the main cable, and then splice that onto my broken wire one. And there's actually a few videos online of people doing exactly that. Seems like the hard part is getting the old wire out, since they put some silicone inside the axle so water can't get in there, which makes sense, but if you're trying to repair it, it's definitely going to get in the way and be a pain in the ass. But it is what it is. And, yeah, hopefully they're pretty similar, but it seems like the 9-pin connector is what, like, practically all e-bikes in this style use. And hopefully when I do it online, if I ever get around to it, it'll be easy enough. So I did try to take apart my hub. It is a little bit different. At least it seems a little bit different, I don't know. But, kind of the same. I can't get the cap off. So I have a feeling I'm going to need to remove the cassette or freewheel, where all the gears are. Maybe I could just remove that like silver core thing? I don't know. I gotta do some more research, but in this guy's video, he can just take the whole cap and freewheel thing off in one go. So, I wish mine was like that, but it isn't. I might need a special tool or something to remove it. But, I'll look into that later, I guess. It's like, yeah, you know, it'd be nice to fix it, but I'm kinda just like, I guess Uber's over and I should really focus harder on getting a regular job. But maybe the bike isn't complete trash at least. And to make sure that the axle doesn't rotate when it's in the dropouts, they do sell these e-bike torque arm kits. They're usually meant for converting a regular bike into an e-bike. Yeah, make it so they won't rotate. And they're a bit beefier than that little washer, so... if I put one of these on each side, I think it wouldn't move. And I could keep using the frame, basically. So, yeah. I'll work on it over time. It's not hopeless again.